Humility is a strength. August 7, 2014. Humanity's evolution has been on the set course for centuries of your time, but in the past few decades, the timetable for your ascension was sped up as your consciousness continued to rise, thanks in part to the incarnations of a plethora of lightworkers and starseeds who've come to the Earth to raise the collective vibration. Now that so many of you are starting to achieve your aims in helping uplift humanity, you're pioneering a loving revolution that'll favor consciousness and awareness over the ignorance that has and continues to hold your society back. When you can see that you have no more reason to keep fighting each other over illusory outer differences, you'll be able to come together much more easily than if you remain separated. Humanity doesn't have to be divided, but you've unfortunately convinced yourselves you are. You've divided yourselves, but this division will be replaced with harmony when everyone on your planet understands that you are and have always been comprised of the same being of Creator Consciousness. Clearing events. We're all composed of Source at our core. Our essence, and the deeper we travel into our personal center, the more we'll find our infinite and all-loving Creator. If everyone on your planet could travel into their sacred center, your collective vibration would rise immensely, and the violence that continues to plague your society would cease in favor of peace and harmony. For your society to enter the higher realms, a lot of clearing events have to take place that, in some cases, seem to involve widespread destruction. Know that everything playing out on the world stage is ultimately necessary for humanity's growth and development, and the areas of your world experiencing heavy turmoil are meant to receive the blessings of the incarnate light workers and starseeds who recognize that it's their mission to offer such blessings. If there's any particular area of your world that you know is experiencing heavy violence and bloodshed, and for most of you, there is, feel free to send your increasingly pure light its way in an effort to help its people find the peace and stability they deserve. Humanity isn't meant to remain divided in this important time of personal and planetary transformation, and as always, if you remain divided within, your society will be divided. A lot needs done to change the defunct manner in which your planet has and continues to run, but like we and plenty of others have said in the past, the most important changes will always come from within. Is it hard to imagine that if every conscious seeker and all of humanity in general made the inner changes that are required before you can build a new, heavenly society, many of the outer changes that need made would become far easier? Is it difficult to believe that raising and refining your vibration while seeking to live in love as often as possible is the best thing you can do for your planet? From our perspective, your vibration is everything. If you could understand just how important your vibration is to the ascension of the planet around you, we are confident that many of you would start the most difficult inner work that you know will lead you to lighten your vibration, helping the world around you as a result. Whenever you're divided within, this division manifests in your society. Whenever you lean on anger, frustration, stress, or any other quality that keeps you from rediscovering the bounties the divine has to offer, you keep the rest of your planet from rediscovering these bounties as well. If you can't find a happy, lively state of mind and heart, it'll seem much harder for the people around you to do so. One of the reasons we mentioned the importance of your presence on the Earth so frequently is because you constantly affect the world around you. You affect every person you have and will ever come into contact with, and realizing this is essential to orienting to love and positivity, letting negativity and division fall away. We don't intend to sound dualistic, and again, finding and remaining in your center is among the best things you can do for yourselves and the world around you. From your center, you'll find a wealth of positive emotions that'll reintroduce you to the higher vibrational joy and clarity that seems missing for so many of you. And for this and plenty of other reasons, we recommend embracing your sacred center more than you already have, and using it to do good in the world. We mentioned in a previous communication that you can use your creativity to create positive change, and we encourage those of you who resonate with this idea to pursue it. Find what you enjoy and use it to help everyone around you and the rest of the planet. Become aware of the necessity to come together with respect for the things you have in common. Your work is important. Your work is very important to the ascension of your planet, And when you can glimpse just how important it is, we are confident that many of you will excitedly embrace it more than you already have. Your work is more valuable than we could hope to express, and hopefully, our reminder of its value will spark the remembrance in each of you of just how necessary it is to your ascension. Meditation and other similar attempts to attune to the energies you're being given will take you far, but your creativity will lead you directly back to the higher realms. Most souls produce creative works from their sacred center because they've found this to be the most flowing way to produce them. And once you find and remain in your center, you can produce a plethora of flowing creative works that'll uplift everyone who's fortunate enough to come across them. Your creativity is a beautiful and important thing, and embracing it will help you prosper when you could have otherwise held yourselves back. As long as you're willing to understand the importance of your creativity and the fact that you can produce flowing creative marvels from your sacred center, your work will be very pure and it'll uplift waves of others who could use upliftment. Your beautiful beings of creator energy who've come to the earth to share your sacred light with the rest of humanity, who've been stuck in a limited frame of mind, and embracing your role is essential to producing anything helpful. Of course, as we've said in the past, everything you do is valuable to humanity's ascension. As long as your intent is pure and you genuinely desire to serve humanity, little else matters. When you're committed to the task at hand, little else will seem to matter except for the flowing work you intend to produce. You'll be able to do far more work than you've let yourselves believe you can, and your level of enthusiasm to contribute to humanity's ascension will be dialed up. There are plenty of reasons for you to understand and embrace the importance of your creative works, and if all of humanity were active in raising consciousness, the planetary vibration would rise immensely, and the changes you've been waiting to see would be kick-started. These changes will have to be created by humanity, but you'll be given plenty of support and assistance with the most difficult aspects of your planetary transformation. The mitigation and cleansing of the widespread pollution that plagues you will be one important area you're given assistance in, and the wealth of higher vibrational technologies humanity has yet to know exist will assist you with the cleanup of landfills and other similar things that hurt the Earth's surface and her underground more than most of your planet realizes. Gaia's crying out for all of the pollution and neglect to end, and you can answer her call by living conscious lifestyles that orient to respect and love for your planet instead of disrespect and misuse. Gaia's waiting to convene with all of her children in a much purer way than she's been able to, but if you can't respect the fact that she's a living, sentient being just like each of you, you'll seem to be blocked from a pure connection with her. She doesn't want you to be blocked from this connection, because she loves all of her children unconditionally and would never want to be separated from them. The love your dear planet has for each of you is deeper than we could hope to express. Despite the fact that humanity continues to pollute and ravage her surface, unaware that an advanced civilization exists underneath her surface who've long monitored all of your society's destructive actions, she still looks to each of you with the utmost love and compassion for the fact that many humans don't know of the damage they've done. Many souls are unaware of just how badly they've inadvertently hurt Gaia, and even some of the conscious public is unaware of just how deep the damage goes. It's grown more concerning than many souls realize, but it's completely within your collective ability to clean up as long as you can come together and find the motivation to start your work. Gaia will help you. Gaia herself will help you with the cleansing of pollution and other similar things from her surface, and as long as you're united and willing to do the heavy lifting that's required to transform your society, the assistance you'll be given will make this transformation relatively easy. Continue to embrace the roles you've come to the earth to fulfill, because again, they're far more important than we could hope to express. By using the creative energy you carry within for myriad important and positive purposes, you help others become aware of the necessity to start their work. Many of you who are very active have inspired waves of others to become just as active, and in doing so, you've strengthened the aforementioned loving revolution, which is growing by the day. With your effort, more and more souls are becoming aware of the necessity to live in love and abandon your old ways, And they're freeing themselves from the self-instated illusion that's kept such a strong grip on the minds and hearts of too many unaware souls who don't realize that simply releasing the darkness is the best way to remove themselves from it. All you need to do is release any tension, stress or frustration that might hold you back to find the clear state of mind so many of you seek. We note that many of you feel very discouraged at the extent to which darkness and the lower qualities that feed it, such as stress, anxiety, etc., seem to creep up and fill your perspective, and when this happens, you can release it in favor of the softer yet stronger qualities of love. As you rediscover love in all of its purity, you'll find that you're tested by any darkness you still carry within. Many of you have made very potent efforts to rid yourselves of this darkness once and for all, seeing to it that it never returns to you, but many conscious seekers still have some inner darkness to work through. Denying its existence will do you no good, and instead, you can cozy up to it in preparation for its transmutation. Don't block it or hide yourselves from it, open up to it, let it out. Give it some air. Recognize its importance to your evolution, and thank it for the role it's played in helping you find a spiritually clear and pure state of mind before releasing it once and for all. To release it, all you need to do is surface it and review it from a detached perspective, understanding the role it's meant to play in helping you thrive, and then, blast as much and as pure light its way as you can. We wholeheartedly recommend reviewing it before you send it off, because sending it off without review could bring it back. Darkness tends to reside within because it's meant to be a catalyst that helps you find the light in greater way, and if you blast light its way before understanding why it sits within in the first place, you'll need to learn the lesson it intended to provide over again, which will usually happen by grappling with it again. Only when you can learn the lesson darkness is intended to provide will you transcend it, and despite how strong or scary it seems, darkness has no real power over you. The only power it has is the power you give to it, and if you give it all of your loving energy and enthusiasm, you'll become depleted. When you can venture deep into the center, the source, you'll find all of the loving and harmonious feelings emotions you've waited so long for, and you'll see that while a lot will be done to transform your society, the greatest changes will start with each of you. You'll create your personal heaven right on earth when you tap into and utilize your sacred center throughout the day, and we're confident that many of you will be able to do so as you come to recognize it and the loving feelings it provides in a clearer way. As you do, we can envision many of you embracing it more than you ever did before, and the result will be that you feel much more lively and able to contribute to the restoration of consciousness. We'll make our final expressions for this communication with appreciation to our scribe and every other scribe out there who's diligently bringing through the energies and expressions of the higher realms. We couldn't be more grateful for the work you're doing, however humble some of your missions may be, and as you'll come to find, humility is a strength. It isn't as much of a weakness as most of your society is comfortable believing, and in fact, unprecedented strength can be found in simplicity. In simply existing and doing the work that resonates with you the most, even if it doesn't put your name in the lights. Fame and recognition aren't your goals in incarnating on the earth, but for some of you, they'll naturally result from the work you're doing. Fame certainly isn't something to strive for, and rather, serving humanity with a loving, open heart is the best goal you can hope to attain. When you can do this, everything else will flow magnificently. Thank you to my higher self and spiritual guides. Channeled through Wes Anak. Cultureofawareness.com